Hi, SofaKingDrunk, here yet again with something completely different to review. This is completely different for me. It's a Buckfast Tonic Wine, 15% on a Richter scale. It's something that I've never tried, to be honest. And I thought, well, SofaKingDrunk, and I thought to myself, well, I'll give it a go. I won a couple of quid, won my Euro Millions, it was about five, and I thought, what could I buy? And I thought, I'll get a wee half bottle of Bucky. Bucky, as it's known, brewed by the Buckfast Abbey down in Devon, 15% on the Richter scale. can't believe I'm doing this. 15% on a Richter scale for this bad boy. It's got its nicknames like Bucky, Rickahoos Juice. The one that I really like is the Coat Bridge Table Wine. Because apparently Coat Bridge in Scotland is the sell, that's its top seller everywhere in Coat Bridge. All the people in Coat Bridge must be all drinking Bucky. It's got its critics, it's got a lot of fans out there. So anyway, we're going to try the tonic and see what we can come up with. Well, actually, you're getting a very, very strong red wine, blackcurrant sort of smell from it. Very much like port. There's a bit of the smell you get from a port as well. I've actually chilled this, and because I spoke to the local the local young team, and they told me it's better off if you chill it. Then someone actually said, make sure there's numbers on the back of the bottle, which I actually googled, and Buckfast Abbey are saying that the numbers on the back of the bottle mean diddly squit. Actually, they've no relation to the wine at all. I think it's something to do with bottling, manufacturing, something along those lines anyway. So anyway, Rickahoos Juice, a tonic. I can't believe I'm drinking this. So anyway, Slangy Va, SofaKingDrunk in here for the Bucky. Well, actually, that is very nice. Believe it or not, I can see how all the young team up and down the land are drinking this stuff, because it's very, very easy to drink. Very easy. Very sort of like, it's got the port smell, it's got the red wine smell as well. And it's very, very, it's very pleasant, very sweet. It's full of caffeine, which obviously you can't taste. It's in the effect, the drunkenness. You get the buzz. Is that what it is? The buzz you get for it. I can see why young people drink this. There's no bitterness about it at all. It's very, very pleasant. I googled it just to see what I could come up with, and it's a Buckfast wine. It's based in a French recipe in the 1890s. Now, I dare say a lot of people out there didn't know that. It's fortified sweet red wine, it's classing itself. It's with added caffeine and flavouring, right? Obviously the caffeine to give you the well-being, that's apparently where it's coming from. Made in the Buckfast Abbey in Devon in England, I think everybody knows that. It's been associated with all sorts of problems all over the UK, mostly in Scotland, where I stay in the Strathclyde region. It's apparently the police for the rest of the UK, but the police They reckon it's a cause of at least 3 crimes a day, Buckfast drinking, because of the high caffeine content, basically, and 15% as well. Like, a couple of young guys like neck a couple of bottles of that. They're off for 3. They're 10 feet high, and they want to take on the world. What else about it? Apparently, this Northern Ireland, it's very big in Northern Ireland as well. Your big cities in Northern Ireland as well. But the only thing is, they don't trust them with a full 15% like they do in Scotland. They're only 14.8 apparently, and it's in a brown bottle. Whereas the Buckfast here is very, very much in a green tinged bottle. So anyway, it's, let's see what else I've got written here. It's also, I touched on the numbers as well. The numbers apparently are related, they're no relation to the wine at all. So anybody out there, it's a Buckfast myth. They say, you look at the numbers in the back of the bottle, and apparently if you get a certain number, it tastes better than another number. Well, that's a lot of shit, actually. So anybody out there just hitting out with that, it's basically, they're talking bish. It's related to the glass bottlers. That's the manufacturing. That's all it is. It's got nicknames, as I touched on. It's Bucky, Rickahoosh Juice, Coatbridge Table Wine. That makes me laugh, that. It likes Mrs. Brown. So that's another thing it's called, Mrs. Brown as well. That must be the Irish Northern Ireland, maybe. If anybody out there, I dare say there'll be a lot of people out there that will know. Is the Mrs. Brown, is that the Scottish or the Irish nickname for it? Rickahoosh Juice and the Coatbridge Table Wine, the Bucky. That seems to be, that'll be the Scottish. So anyway, it's also very famous as well in TV and films. Also TV, you've got Rab and Jamesy, Rab C. Nisbet and Jamesy Cotter. They went a pilgrimage to the Buckfast Abbey. You've also got in Trainspotting. There was the final scene with Renton when he buggers off with all the cash. There was a bottle of Bucky sitting up in the mantelpiece for all those, I think it was Bigby's, it must have been Bigby's Buckfast, in Trainspotting. And also in The Simpsons as well, Groundskeeper Willie. Yeah, he liked a wee glass of Bucky as well. So anyway, as I said, it's actually quite pleasant, to be honest with you. There's no point in saying it's shit. It's actually got a bit of creaminess about it as well. It's you've got the smell of the port, and you've got the red wine kind of smell as well. And what you're getting on the taste is a nice creamy, it's quite creamy. It's like some, would I drink it again? Probably not. It's a powerful brew. I can see why young people are attracted to it. It's very pleasant. And like so, look at that, it's wine. I put it in a wine glass as well. Very, very dark in colour. Very easy to drink. Available up and down the street, all over the UK. I don't really know what else to say about this, but see, to be honest with you, actually, it's got a bit of black cunt. It's like black cunt jam as well. Like so, after you've drank it, your whole mouth's coated with this kind of currants, like black currant. So anyway, if you see the Bucky out there, the Rickahoosh Juice, Coatbridge Table Wine, whatever you want to call it, have a go at it, because you know something, like so, I bought it as a spoof, to be honest with you, and to be honest with you, it's not actually that bad. I can see the attraction for the young people. Very, very sweet. Well, anyway, this is SofaKingDrunk with
review of the Buckfast Table Wine, Rick Hoos Juice, Mrs. Brown, Coatbridge Table Wine, whatever you want to call it. Give it a go. You like it, you don't. I'm going to give that a SofaKingDrunk rating, and it's going to be the only thing I'm doing. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5. Yo, Bucky! Know what I mean, man? Good stuff. Enjoy, and maybe see you again in something completely different review. Ciao for now.